So this lecture will describe about the quality control. So before going to the quality control, this will be in the different 2-3 lectures, I think. In one lecture it will not be covered. So before going to the quality control, just let us see with the lab technicians or the persons who are opening a laboratory, what is their motto or goal. So before opening a laboratory, everyone should might have some questions within his mind, or the personnel who are working in the laboratory, they might have some questions. Who are customers? Are the customers or the patient? What do they require? They require a report which is genuine and authentic. How we can deliver what they need? This can be done only by proper management of the laboratory or quality control. What are the succeeding? Are we succeeding in this effort? Whether if it is not, then we have to try for it. If not, then what we do differently? So what we can do differently so that we can provide a report sufficiently, or accurate report can be provided to the patients. So in a healthcare system, everywhere, it depends upon the technicians or the doctors or the nurse, but the persons or the customers benefit, or if you provide them a good support or good environment or good laboratory report, everything will be helpful for the patients. So for that, for what we are doing this, we have to do some work or some management part, or we have to go through some procedures by which we can provide this type of quality report. So why you are doing this? To meet the customer's need. Customers means here the patients. So we have to meet the customer's need. How? By providing quality or quality product. So how it can be defined? Quality is nothing but the meeting of the customer's requirement for a product or service. So either we are providing a product or we are providing a service, it must be of good quality. So how, what is the goal of the quality? The general goal of the quality is to meet the requirements on the time. That means the first time you are providing the report, that should be authentic one, because the customer will not come to you in the second time if you are giving the erroneous report. So the first time with no error or defect. So this is the goal of maintenance of the quality control. And in every system, this quality control can be achieved by a good quality control management system. And this management system is called as total quality management. It is called as total quality management. And this total quality management is to provide a management philosophy for organizational development and management process for improving the quality of all the aspects of the work. It starts from the workers, instrument, equipments, in case of laboratory, instrument, equipments, standardization of the laboratory, everything, every aspect has to be checked here to provide a good quality report. So, the total quality management system actually consisting of quality laboratory process. So, you are having a quality laboratory process, then you are able to provide the good report or authentic report or report having less error or no error. And quality assessment, that is another component, and that is then quality assurance, that is also another component, and then quality control. So all these things, all these frameworks are related to providing the good quality report to the patients so that they cannot suffer. So, in this lecture, I will cover only the quality laboratory processes. So, before a quality laboratory process is discussing of the quality laboratory process, how it can be achieved. Before setting up a laboratory, we should keep in the mind what is the exact location of the laboratory, and we have to maintain the construction related legal documents. If the laboratory is having some legal deficiency, then that lab cannot be run properly. Next, the schematic design of the laboratory should be there. It should start from the, what I can say, from the plumbing, from the designing of the tables, from the electric supply, or everything. Every aspect has to be designed in such a way that these designs or these arrangements of the laboratory do not affect the quality of the services we are providing. Then the staff recruitment policies. These policies also should be fixed in such a way that the specific type of staffs can be recruited. So the staff's quality and their recruitment policy is another important factor for maintaining a total good laboratory. Then the maintenance of the staff attendance register is very important. The maintenance of the staff, whether the staff is attending the laboratory properly or not, that is also a very important factor. And that actually denotes his eagerness to work with the laboratories. Next, inventory control policies are also an important component. Then the procedure of purchase of instrument, how we are purchasing the instrument, what are the procedures. We cannot purchase the different types of instruments, the instruments having less quality. Before purchasing of the instrument, the quality and aspects of the facilities, whatever the instrument is providing to us, that has to be analyzed or compared with it from the different companies by receiving the tenders or like that, and then it can be purchased. So the maintenance of the instrument and equipment. It is the record of maintenance of the equipment and instrument purchasing. Not only the purchasing, the how you are maintaining the instruments and how you are maintaining the equipments, that is also very important, and that is very important for providing quality report to the patients. And record of standardization of the instrument, and because standardization of the instrument requires periodical standardization. Until or unless you are going through the periodical standardization, the instrument may be erroneous and it will produce a bad report or report with errors. So to avoid this, the instrument should be standardized on a regular basis, and that should be recorded and should be kept in the record, that it either it is weekly or monthly or bi-monthly, like that. Then the policies to purchase the chemicals, reagents and diagnostic kit, they are also very important factor for maintenance of the quality of the laboratory. So the chemicals you are purchasing, the reagents or diagnostic kit, that must be of sufficient, whether they are maintaining their quality or not, that is also should be checked. And there are different types of companies which provides different types of chemicals and reagents which cannot produce the good results. So by this process, by changing or by regulating your policies of purchase of chemicals, reagents and diagnostic kit, you can maintain the quality of your laboratory also. By maintenance of the standard operating procedure, so every laboratory have to follow a standard operating procedure which are called as SOP, and these SOPs are may differ from lab to lab, but their main motto or main goal is to provide a quality report. And the record of quality control measures, there are different types of measures which can be taken of for maintenance of the quality, and that should be recorded. Everything should be recorded, whether it is being recorded, whether it is being in a regular basis or not, that must be recorded. Then the maintenance of the records of the patient, that is also very important factor. The patients who are coming, their record must be kept in a for a particular duration, so that the in future it can be used or it can be provided if there is any medical legal issues are there. So that is very important for the maintenance of the records of the patient. And maintenance of all the instrument, equipments and basic infrastructure of the laboratory. Don't think that without the basic structure, infrastructure of the laboratory cannot run properly. So the basic infrastructure of the laboratory is also another important factor along with the instruments and equipment. So every aspect, from starting from the workers to the instrument to the and to infrastructure, everything is necessary for providing a good quality report. Then the arrangement of the first aid kit, it is required in every laboratory. As you know, the laboratories as regions where the hazards, where the accidents might occur frequently, and there are chances of occurrence of the accidents. So first aid kits are very essential, and the material safety data sheet, every reagent having a sheet which is called as material safety data sheet. Within that sheet, everything has been mentioned about that particular reagent or chemical or like that. And these safety sheets should be kept or arranged in a such a way that it can be available very easily. So that if a person is affected by, so when they are used, they are required, they can be read out properly and they can be followed properly. So this material safety data sheet for every chemicals, every reagents is very important and is essential for storing in every laboratory in a proper way. So other factors, there are the provisions of the fire prevention facilities, that is also very important factor nowadays, and provisions of waste disposal system. Whatever the waste are coming from the laboratory, either they are the biohazards or they are some substances which are very pathogenic substances, so that they can be disposed in such a way that they do not create any environmental pollution or like that. Then the it can be done by using different waste disposal system, sewage treatment plants, by implanting sewage disposal plant or like that. Then the provision of the disposal of storage and biohazards waste and SARP items. So there's in every laboratory who are maintaining a quality report, who are able to provide quality report, they should have the disposal storage and biohazards waste as well as the SARP items that can be disposed in a proper way. And the laboratory must have the provision of personal protective equipments like gloves, laboratory coats, goggles, etc., so that the workers can be protected from the different accidents or pathogenic substances. And this is very important also for the health of the workers also. Then the provision for supplying safe drinking water and arrangement for the specific space for the staff for the breakfast and lunch. So the arrangement of food should be separate from the laboratory testing areas, and that must be separated from the original laboratory testing area so that the contamination or as well as the infection cannot spread it through the workers or laboratory technicians. So provisions of the laboratory standard books also, the laboratory should have the library having the standard books and books related to the medical legal aspects. So everything has to be kept in the particular laboratory library so that it can be accessed by the technicians as well as the staffs who are working in the laboratories. Then the laboratory should keep the records of the staff vacations, when they are about their vacations, their in-service education programs, how they are achieving, and very important, the continuous medical education programs, the participation of the technicians as well as the laboratory personnel in the continuous medical education programs, as because the medical education is changing very drastically day by day. So every person has to be refreshed after a particular period. So that's why the participation in continuous medical education or CME programs are very important, and periodic evaluation of the competency of the laboratory personnel, whether they are doing works properly or not, that evaluation is also very important factor. Next point is the record of financial aspects and yearly balance sheet. Financial aspects and yearly balance sheet is also very important factor. This actually tells about the commercial, that is the monetary related, money related matter. That means every laboratory needs some money to run, so that must be these financial aspects must be audited in a proper way in a particular duration. It might be yearly. Then the record of performance of appraisal of the staff, that is also very important. What the performance of staffs are showing, that must be kept in a record with the help of the appraisal sheets. Then the record of meeting of supervisor staff, superior staff with the subordinate staffs. So that is also very important. So the regular meeting with the superior staff with the subordinate staffs So it is very important. Then record of internal and external audits. So record of internal and external audits. What do you mean by internal audits and what is by external audit? So internal audits are generally done by the superior staff of the laboratory, who actually checks whatever is going on. It is done by checking all the records, starting from the purchasing of the instrument, chemicals, reagents, kits, and the standardization of the equipments. Everything is done by the internal auditors. They are nothing but the superior staff of the laboratory. And external auditors means we have to hire some expert from the different external auditor agencies who will judge this report and certify the laboratory that they are maintaining the quality. Okay, thank you. On next classes, I will discuss about another three aspects of the laboratory management system. Quality, that means the quality laboratory management system.